I don't know if you can see me. There's so much sun in this room, but never mind. I really want to do this live because I only have like 10 minutes. And my boys will come home and there'll be lots of noise, and in the evening I'll be tired. So I want to share my message with you right now. And I am Ashka Koltan, the founder of Get Ready for Love, the dating detox expert. And I work with single women who are frustrated with dating and struggling to find the right kind of man. And I help them to go within and start loving and valuing themselves more. So they stop making the same mistakes in love over and over again. They start making more empowered romantic choices, and they finally attract true love into their lives. And today I want to talk about being single and how to be more loving towards yourself while you are being single, especially now, around Valentine's Day. And I know many single women get triggered by this day and they want to kind of hide away and ignore it, or they feel a little bit down and it affects their well-being and all that stuff. So it prompted me to, hello Claire, how are you doing? It prompted me to talk about it because I also have something amazing for you, which you can join and make this day absolutely special for you. It doesn't have to be sad, it doesn't have to suck, it can be a cool day. So, how can you be extra loving with yourself when you are single? First thing you need to do is stop identifying with the relationship status. It means nothing. I mean, it means one thing, that you don't have a partner. The same like being in a relationship means you have a partner. But it means nothing about your worthiness. It means nothing about your value. It doesn't mean you are less worthy or less lovable because you are single. It means that to you when you start building stories. Like, for example, I'm single because I'm not attractive. I'm single because nobody really is interested in me. I'm single because there are no good men out there and everyone is taken. So when you start building the stories and you start believing them, that affects your worthiness and the way you feel about yourself. And very often, I mean, I used to feel like that. I used to feel crap when I used to be single. I thought there was something wrong with me. I thought it was all my fault and I had to do something or change myself or become someone else to attract the love of my life, which is absolutely crap. And I don't believe these things anymore, but I've done lots of work around it. So it's much easier for me to see the truth because I'm on the other side. I am in a relationship, but I don't feel any better for that. I don't feel more valuable because I have a partner. I felt like that before I met him. And he is a bonus in my life and he enriches my life, but I'll be absolutely fine if he wasn't part of my life. If I can explain it this way. So don't identify with your relationship status. It only means you currently don't have a partner because you are either getting ready for it, you need to do more inner work to actually align yourself with him, and you are in a transition in between relationships. And most of all, you are in a relationship with yourself, the most important relationship you will ever have, and the only one guaranteed one, the only guaranteed one. So the second thing is, don't judge yourself, don't blame yourself for being single. It's not your fault. And I constantly hear it from single women I work with and I have discovery calls with, there must be something wrong with me. And I used to feel the same. No, there's nothing wrong with you. You are amazing. You are fabulous the way you are, but you just have to start seeing it, and you just have to recognize your value and your worth, because only then other people will be able to see it. Hello, Melanie. Valentine's is about celebrating love in all its forms. Yes, I celebrate Valentine's with my beautiful babies as another excuse to shower me and them with even more love. Amazing. So that is the attitude I want to encourage as well. And that brings me to the final point. Don't exclude yourself from life. So, for example, now the Valentine's Day is coming and many single women want to retreat and take a step back because they believe it's a day for couples, for romantic love. No, decide to celebrate it your own way. Create your own rules. It can be a day to celebrate yourself. It can be a day to shower yourself with self-love, to spoil yourself rotten. You can have an amazing day if you decide to do it and you make a little bit of effort. And this is what Melanie has mentioned. You celebrate it. It's just another excuse to celebrate love. And as Valentine's Day is about love, it doesn't have to be necessarily about just romantic love. You make it a self-love day. And if you are up for a challenge and you want to make this day extra special for yourself, how about you join my challenge, Romancing Yourself Challenge for Single Ladies? I have already 70 women, so the topic is really on point. They are just signing up without me doing much because they really want to focus on themselves and prioritize themselves and spoil themselves, pamper themselves, and create that special space for yourself. So I'm gonna post a link to the challenge below. And if you feel like joining us and the other 70 women, please do so. And I'll be more than happy to have you on the challenge. And I promise you, it's gonna be amazing. And it's going to last for 7 days. So it's not going to be just on the Valentine's Day. We are starting this Sunday on the 11th of February. And my intention is to make all these women forget about the Valentine's Day blues and focus on themselves and have fun and towards the end feel absolutely amazing. So please join us and let me just post it. Hey Claire, I know, I don't know what has happened. So let me just paste it and I really need to finish because I can hear my boys knocking on the door. Keep well, everybody.